Vasudevaya.
Om namo Bhagavate 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 Vasudevaya.
Rishibhir,
Bahudha,
Gitam,
Chandobhir,
Vividhai,
Pritak,
Brahma,
Sutra,
Pradesh,
Shaiva,
Hetumadbhir,
Vinishchitai,
Rishibhir Bahudha Gitam,
Chandobhi Vividaik Pritak,
Brahma Sutra Padaishchaiva, Hetumadbhir Vinishchitai, Rishibhir,
by the wise sages,
Bahudha,
in many ways,
Gitam,
described,
Chandobhi,
Vedikims,
Vividhai,
in various,
Pritak,
variously,
Brahmasutra,
the Vedanta,
Padai,
Aphorism.
Also.
Eva.
Certainly.
Hetumadbhi.
With cause and effect.
Vinishchitai.
Ascertain. Translation. That knowledge of the field of activities and of the knower of activities is described by various sages in various Vedic writings, especially in the Vedānta-sūtra, and is presented with all reasoning as to cause and effect.
So, about the soul and super soul, Rishi, great sages, friendly persons, they have also discussed. Just like in the present age also, we are different parties, the impersonalist and the personalist, the Sankara Sampradaya, they ascertain the absolute truth as impersonal, nirvishesha. And the Buddhists, they ascertain the absolute truth is zero. We are struggling nirvishesha sunnavadi. We are struggling against this nirvishesha sunnavadi, voidist and impersonalist. So it is not now new. From time immemorial there are different views. But Krishna refers here with Brahma Sutra Padai, Hetumadbhi Vinishchita. Others, there are many other books of knowledge. They are not very reasonable. That is dogmatic. But Hetumadbhi, if we accept with our logic and sense, that is first class book which gives us information of the Atma Paramatma. Therefore, in the Chaitanya Chaitamrita, the author says, Chaitanya dayar katha karah vichar. Vichar karile chitte bhave chamatkar. The author says that you kindly put your consideration or judgment about the mercy of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And if you consider with logic and reason, vichar karile, pavi chitte chamatkar, you'll feel that these are wonderful things. So we haven't got to accept anything blind. The Brahma Sutra and Vedanta Sutra is called Naya Prasthan. There are three different processes for understanding the Absolute Truth. Naya Prasthan, Shruti Prasthan, Smriti Prasthan. The Brahma Sutra is Naya Prasthan. Naya Prasthan means everything, all the sutras and codes are there with full reasoning. Hetu Madhvi Vinishchiti. And whatever Brahma Sutra says, that is Vinishchita, means ascertained. There is no doubt. Just like Brahma Sutra says, Athato Brahma Jigyasa, Brahma Sutra says, now it is the time for inquiring about the Absolute Truth. Now means, in this life, human form of life, or just like in Europe and America, it is the time now to inquire of the Absolute Truth. Because materially they are advanced. They have seen all material advancement. The scientists are now perplexed that how we shall maintain ourselves, because we have nothing to give anymore. Whatever stock we had, that is finished. Now they are simply to bluff. No more stock to give. They have given us motor car and atomic bomb and aeroplane and electronic activities. So many things they have given. That's all right. Simply they could not give us relief from birth, death, old age and disease. The real problems are there, but they have given some superfluous. Just like this is also scientific improvement, microphone. But the microphone sometimes goes wrong, that does not mean I stop speaking. We can do without microphone. That is not a very great problem. Suppose science has given us motor car, that's all right. But sometimes without motor car we walk, or there is bullock cart. The real problem which very much disturbing us, that all of us do not want to die. But the science could not give us any formula assuring that there is no more death. That is not possible. So, athāta brahma jigyāsa, as I was talking, then in the Western countries, Europe and America, about 40 years ago, sometimes in the year 1935-36, about 40 years ago, or little less, one of my godbrother, German, his name is still living, he is now in Switzerland. He has taken the name of, what is the name?
Sadanand,
yes. His real name is Sulje, German. So, when he came to India, in a meeting he said that so far mystic power is concerned, that we have solved by science. We have nothing to learn about the mystic power. I have come to India to learn how to understand God and His service, loving service. So actually, that is the position 40 years ago he said, so Europe and America, they have enough of material enjoyment. Meat eating, wine, oven, they have got sufficient. So they are not very much interested with all these things, although because they have no other alternative for enjoyment, so they are enjoying or trying to satisfy them, but that is not giving them real satisfaction. That's a fact. This wine, oven and meat eating, that is not giving them any more satisfaction. But because they have no other alternative, what they can do? Punap punap charvita charvananam, chewing the chewed, that's all. It is already chewed, it is already tasted. But there is no other alternative, therefore they are tasting the same thing, this way and that way. So, their time is now Athata Brahma Jignasa. Therefore, from India, any rascal comes as yogi and sadhu and avatar, they go, they are hankering after. You see, practically, this younger generation, they ask me sometimes, why so many younger generation come to you? Yes, they are frustrated. They are no more interested to live like their fathers and grandfathers. That has become hackneyed. The same things, same gambling, same meat eating, same woman hunting and same intoxication, that has finished. So, when one has finished his material enjoyment, then the next question is Brahma Sankha, Athato Brahma Jignasa. They try to inquire about the Absolute Truth. That is natural sequence. Therefore, Vedānta-sūtra, the first aphorism is Athato Brahma Jignasa. Yes, that is natural. As you are, you young boys and girls, why you are after me? The natural sequence is that now we have to inquire what is the next, because this material happiness has not given us any happiness actually. So, when a man becomes civilized, when a man has enjoyed enough of the so-called material, the next inquiry is about the Absolute Truth, that is natural. That is natural. Because every living entity is a spiritual spark. He is not this body. Therefore, Krishna has already explained. To understand what the Khetragya, the knower of the body, and to understand what is this body, Khetragya, and who is the another real proprietor of the body, Krishna, Khetragya cha pi manga vidhi. So, if one can understand these three things, Khetra, Khetragya and the Supreme Khetragya, even by common sense we can understand, it requires little cool brain. But that cool brain cannot act without giving up these four things, namely, illicit sex, meat eating, intoxication and gambling. If your brain is congested always with all these four rubbish things, you cannot think of higher, finer things. That is not possible. Therefore, we restrict to make the brain clear to understand about Krishna. Parikshit Maharaj said, Vina pasuna nirvitta tarasai rupagiyamana bhavau sadhi chotra mano virama kautamasloka gunanubada vidajati vinapasugna. Vinapasugna. These are the shastric injunctions. The meat eaters, they have no brain to understand about the Absolute. They simply speculate. They cannot understand. It's not possible. That is the Parikshit Maharaj says, Bina Pusugna, except the rascals who are accustomed to kill animals, all, everyone will take shelter of the glorification of the Lord. Except these persons, Bina Pusugna. He says, Nidvitta Tarsai Rupagiyamana, glorification of the Lord. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama. It is chanted by the liberated person. It is not chanted by the conditioned soul. It is not possible. Therefore, not everyone can chant. You have seen it, experience, that you are chanting, dancing is very in ecstasy, emotion. Others are standing without opening their mouth. They cannot chant. That is a very difficult job for them. Because it is the property of the liberated person, not for the conditioned soul. Therefore, Parikshit Maharaj said, Nirvitta Tarsai. Tarsai, Trishna. Trishna means hankering. Just like if you are thirsty, you feel, where is water, where is water, where is water? That is called Trishna. So, Nirvitta Tarsai means one who has finished all hankering for material enjoyment. He is called Nirvitta Trishna. Nirvitta means finished. And Trishna means hankering. As the same thing is described in the Bhagavad Gita, Brahma Bhuta Prasannatma Nasochati Nakankati. Kankati. Kankati means if I hanker, that means still I am hungry or thirsty. But there is a position, Brahma Bhuta position, by Brahma Jigyasa, that we can get relief of these two activities, hankering and lament. The material world, there are two things only, lamenting and hankering. Those who do not possess his hankering, and those who have lost their lamenting. But there are two things only. Actually, you do not possess. Somehow or other, if we possess, that is also lost. Just like we have got this body. Khetraga, khetra, khetraga. Khetra is this body. So, by hankering, by desiring, you can get any type of body. There are 8,400,000 of bodies. Just if you are eager to get a certain type of body or certain type of standard of living, Krishna will give you. Jita thamaṁ prapadyante tāṁ sathaiva bhajāmaham. Because here it is the business, Krishna's business is these rascals, these conditioned souls, they want to lord it over this material world. And Krishna has to supply them. That is Krishna's business in this world. Simply bothering. Just like so many children. The father is put into difficulty. One child wants, father give me this. Another child says, my father give me this, give me that, give me that. And father being affectionate, he has to satisfy all the children. So Krishna's position is like that. Therefore, Krishna comes being bothered by these rascals. that you want from me so many things, but you are not happy. Please, therefore, give up this business. Sarva dharman parityaj. Mamekam sarva. Just become. Follow me, you'll be happy. Therefore, Krishna comes. Real solution is that, Krishna consciousness. Therefore, the Vedānta-sūtra says, athāta brahma jigyāsa. Now you don't inquire for any other things. Why should you? All other things required by you, that is already supplied, it will be supplied. Why you bother? You just try to understand the value of your life in Krishna consciousness. That is your only business. Tasyaiva heta prajateta kovida. Kovida, those who are intelligent. Tasyaiva heta, for that thing. Prajateta endeavor. So try to get that thing. For that thing. Nalabhati jat bhramatam uparajadha. Just like people are struggling wherever you go, material world. Either you go to London or go to Paris or to Calcutta or Bombay, anywhere you go. What is the business? Everyone is struggling. Day and night the motor car going this way, that way, this way, that way. Last night I was speaking with Sudhakirti. Whenever you see this nonsense thing, go. Any city you go. The same road, same motor car, same hoosh, same petrol, that's all. What is the difference? But we say, this is called illusion. I have come to Paris, I have come to Calcutta. But what is the difference between Calcutta and Paris and Bombay? The same thing. Punacchari, vitacharvanana. Again and again, chewing the chew, that's all. Therefore, the Brahma Sutra advises, now you have done this chewing the chew, so many lives. Chewing the chew means ahara nidra bhaya maithunancha. Either you are dog or you are man. You have to make solution how to eat, how to sleep, how to satisfy your sex, and how to defend. The same problem is in the dog life, the same life problem is the human life. Same life is in the demigod life also. Just like our Bhagavad Das was telling me that in Paris they are levying taxes 20% for maintaining the expenditure of atomic bomb. So we are simply creating problems. That's all. The so-called advancement of civilization means the same problem. Atomic bomb, what is that? Defensing. Ahara nidra bhaya. Bhaya means fearfulness. Because we are afraid, either English or France or German, everyone is afraid. Just like a dog is afraid whether another dog is coming. So the so-called civilized men, they are also afraid whether Englishmen are coming to attack or the Germans. Therefore, there must be atomic bomb I shall throw. Therefore, you must give me tax. These things are simply the trying to solve the problems of fearfulness. That's all. Defense. So this fearfulness is there in the dog, in the hog, in the small sparrow, bird, everywhere. You have seen the sparrow, bird. As soon as on the land, want to eat something, he's afraid. Is not somebody coming to kill me? This, everywhere, in the aquatic also. Everyone is afraid for life. But Krishna has given them different types of defensive measures. It is learned from the Shastra that the fish, they can, by the waves of the water, they can understand that few miles ahead there is enemy. They can understand. And they become immediately defensive, how to protect. because this is struggle for existence. I want to eat you, you want to eat me. Jiva jiva sa jivanam. This is going on. So everyone is afraid, everyone is taking defense. Even tiger is also afraid. Do you know that? Tiger is also afraid. Tiger has become very powerful animal. Everyone is afraid of. He can catch anyone and kill him and eat him. Unfortunately, he does not get the opportunity of catching anyone. The tiger cannot eat every day very nicely. He gets once in a week a chance, or once in a fortnight a chance to capture an animal. Therefore he kills and keeps it for eating daily. It is not that just like you are getting daily Bhagavad prasadam, nice dish. Nobody is applying to tiger. Nobody is going to tiger's prawn, sir, kindly kill me and eat. No, nobody is going to. Everyone has got to struggle. Nahi suptasya singhasya pravishanti mukhe mriga. This is the statement. This material world is so bad that even the lion, if he keeps himself sleeping, because lion is considered to be the king of the forest. So if he thinks that I am the king of the forest, so why shall I what? Let me sleep. And my eating animals will come and enter into my mouth. No. You have to struggle. You have to find out. Therefore, this energy is called karma sangha anna. There are many energies of Krishna. Prasa shakti vividhaiva sriyate. But learned scholars, they have divided into three. The spiritual energy, the marginal energy and the material energy. Titya karma sangha anya, titya shakti rishyate. So here this material world, either you become a tiger, either you become Lord Brahma, or you become a small ant. You have to struggle for your existence. This is material world. You cannot think that I shall be happy without any working. People are trying to do that. That when a man gets some money, bank balance, he no more work. But that is the tendency that without working, I shall maintain myself happily. That is our tendency. Anandamaya Abhyasa, Vedānta-sūtra says, because our tendency is to enjoy life, but we do not know where to enjoy, how to enjoy. And that is called illusion. We are trying to enjoy life in this material world where there is no enjoyment. There is no enjoyment. Repeatedly, Shastra says, Krishna said, Dukkhalayam asasatam. This place is simply for miserable condition of life. Dukkhalayam asasatam. And still, it is temporary. Even if you think, all right, there are so many miserable conditions, never mind. Let me adjust and live here permanently. Oh no, that is also not allowed. Temporary. You may decorate your Paris city, Napoleon tried and other tried, but you cannot live here, sir. You have to go out. But these rascals, they do not understand. They are decorated. Decorate. Tax. Give more tax. Give more tax. Let us decorate. But how long you shall live in this decorated city? Even if you live, if you are so much lover, great nationalist of the country, suppose next life you get the... because when one has very much attraction for a certain land, then he again takes birth in that land. So if you take your birth not as human being or as a cat and dog or a cow, then you will be sent to the slaughterhouse. Then what is the use of your becoming nationalist? Your man for whom you have worked so hard, next life, if you take your birth as a cow, the same man will send you to the slaughterhouse. But these rascals do not know what is the mystery. Therefore, to make solution of this problem, athāta brahma jignāsa, now inquire what is the absolute truth. That is intelligence. Therefore, Krishna, although he is Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, he is giving reference to the Brahma Sutra. Whatever he speaks is online. He doesn't require to refer any authoritative book. But he is also giving. You have seen Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. That is the way. But these rascals are trying to avoid authoritative scriptures. Even Krishna is giving reference to the authoritative scripture. And these rascals, they have so degraded. They said, oh, why this book? Now I can manufacture own knowledge. And other rascals are accepting, yes, it is right. So this is called Kali Yuga. People are so degraded, less than animals, less than animals. Therefore, to revive them, the Vedānta-sūtra says, athāta brahma jignāsa. Now we inquire about the absolute truth. Hetu madhvi vinishchitam. Now hetu madhvi means with reason. Reason, what is that reason? Now if I want to inquire about the absolute truth, so how I shall understand? Now, there are three ways, namely, pratyakha, Aitijya and Suti. Suti Praman. Suti Praman, Pratyakha Praman, direct perception. Now Brahma, the absolute truth. How we can understand the absolute truth? Absolute truth means the supreme. Now we have got experience that everything is created by somebody. Everything, whatever we see. This pillow, this seat, or this book, or this microphone, whatever we are saying, even my body is created by my father and mother. Everyone can understand. So why they should deny the creation of this material world? We see everything material that has got a beginning, date of birth and date of death, and there are in the middle, between the birth and death, there is disease and old age, deterioration. Old age means deterioration. Just like this body. When I was a young man, child, I was also jumping. Now I have to go with a stick. Deterioration, this is called deterioration. Deterioration means now it is coming to be finished. There are six changes. First of all, birth, then living for some time, then producing some byproduct, then deterioration, then finish. Janma, sthiti, there are six kinds of changes. So anything material, you study. These six kinds of changes are there. So this material world, how this rascal says that it was existing? It was existing. Nothing was existing. Otherwise, why the Brahma Sutra says, janma adasya jataha, the absolute truth is that from whom or from which everything is taking birth. This is Brahma Sutra. So everything is taking birth, means this material world also has taken birth from that Absolute Truth. That is answered in the Bhagavad Gita. Aham sarvasya prabhava matta sarvam pravartate. Krishna said that I am the origin of all births, everything. So the material world is not existing. This is insufficient. How you can say it is existing? Anything you see material, it has got a date of birth. Who can deny it? Can you present anything material which has no beginning? Everything has got beginning. So how you can say this material world has no beginning? This is nonsense. Therefore, hetu man vibhinishchitai. Hetu means with reason, not like dogmatic obstinacy. You must have to believe. Then as soon as we accept that this material world has a beginning, the Shastra says it has beginning, just like Brahma says, janmadasya jata. Why it says janmadasya? Everything has beginning. And we see from the Shastra how this material has begun. There was, first of all, Mahavishnu. From Mahavishnu, these universes came out. Jasaika nishasita kalama thavalamba jivanti loma vilaja jagadanna natha Vishnu mahansa yajasya kalavishishu govindamadi purisam tamahangaya. Before this universal creation, Krishna took the form of Mahavishnu. And Mahavishnu's breathing period is the creation and annihilation. So long the breathing goes on, exhaling, and that is the creation period. Inhaling, the discharge, annihilation. So the whole cosmic manifestation is being maintained within the breathing period of Mahavishnu. Jasaika nishasita kalama thavalamba jivanti loma vilaja jagadarnanatha. Jagadarn Brahma. Brahma is the supreme living being within this universe. But it is plural number, jagadarnanatha. So there are innumerable universes. So if we discuss all these things from the Shastra, then we get really knowledge, and then we can actually act what is the perfection of life. Therefore Krishna suggests Brahma-sutra padaishchaiva hetumad vivinishthita. Try to understand Brahma-sutra, Vedanta philosophy. Vedanta philosophy is explained Srimad Bhagavatam. That is the real commentary of Vedānta-sūtra. You cannot understand Vedānta-sūtra as it is, because it is mentioned in codes. Just like you have got business, Bentley's code, one small word, but that it has got a big sentence. Just like in business, they write Bentley's CIF. So CIF means it is this sort. That's what we say ISKCON. ISKCON means I means international, S means society, and K means Krishna consciousness. So Krishna and CON means consciousness. As we have simplified, similarly there are many things, codes. So in the Vedanta Sutra means there are codes, but in each code there is ample meaning. So that is commentary. So Vedanta Sutra says, Janmadasya Jataha, simply two words. Bhagavat explains. Bhagavat says, Janmadasya Jataha, Yanaya Titaratascha, Arthisu Abhigya Sarat, Tini Brahmarida Adikavai Mahiyanti Jatsuraya. Explanation. So similarly, atāto brahma jigyāsa, and Bhagavata, jīvasya tattva jigyāsa, So the same thing is explained in the Srimad Bhagavad. First of all, the whole Vedic knowledge is summarized in Vedānta-sūtra by Vyāsa. And again he explained under the instruction of Narada, the Bhagavatam, Brahma-sūtra. So Brahma-sūtra-padaiścaiva iti-mad-vibhinishthitam. So one has to take lesson from Bhagavad, Brahma-sūtra, Bhagavad Gita, not that they reject all these books, then that lesson the other day one, another crazy came, he said, I am poet. What kind of poet? I have no aim of life. That's all. I am such a big poet that I have no aim of life. I think we are taking too much time. Yes. Thank you very much. Come on.